Our next speaker, Yin Qu, is from the University of Texas.
Texas A&M. Good morning, everyone. I'm Yin Qu, and my advisor is Andruid, Kerne, and we are here to present our work on interoperable metadata semantics. What is metadata semantics? So we define metadata semantics as the conjunction between a document and its content, its descriptions, its operations, and its relations. So let's look at an example like this. This is an article from New York Times. We see that in addition to its content, we have those descriptions like region and the relations in the form of hyperlinks and operations like share, email, so that you can send it to your friends. And also, there are all the kinds of metadata semantics on the web in different forms, like RSS feeds, like patent repository, and digital libraries, and products, and so on. So these metadata semantics are useful in applications, but there are some problems with it to use them in applications. Like one problem is that most of the metadata semantics are represented in HTML files, which you cannot use directly. Typically, you cannot use directly in your programs. And different sources may use different forms, like even they are using the same schema. So if you want to use metadata semantics from different sources, you need to deal with them individually, which is not convenient. So this makes it difficult to obtain, to use, and to exchange between systems. So we have some people have proposed the solutions for those problems. Like we have all the metadata standards like Dublin Core and MARC and others. And so metadata semantics in those written in these standards can you can use them without knowing the sources. And however, the standardization process is slow, so it cannot scale up. It can hardly scale up with the web. Then we have the semantic web approach, which is a very, very general way to describe metadata semantics. However, the availability is quite limited, at least on today's web. We have also those alternative semantic web ways, like PiggyBank, which uses JavaScript-based scrapers to scrape metadata semantics from documents. And we also have microdata, which allows publisher to embed semantics in HTML pages. So our objective in this work is to implement interoperable metadata semantics, which is obtained from different sources, but translated into a consistent representation that you can use directly in your program and also without knowing the sources. And so we have this software called Meta-Metadata, which is a language for authoring wrappers. Wrappers define the metadata schema and extraction or presentation rules. And it is also an architecture for extracting and translating metadata semantics from documents to your application and take actions on them. Basically, actions are operations. And it is also a repository of authored wrappers, so you don't have to start from scratch every time. And it is an open source software, so everybody can use it. Here is the overview of the architecture. And I will go through the details with a use case of integrating search results from different search engines. Let's look at the authoring process first. So this is a typical search result from Google, which has a heading, a link, and a snippet from the document it refers to. And we can use this wrapper to model this metadata schema. It's pretty straightforward here. You can see the heading snippet link there. With this definition of search result, we can define a search as the as a collection of search results, as you see here. It's a collection of search results. And this semantic action basically iterates over each search result and go to that URL and to see if there are new semantics we can use. It's basically a crawling action. And all the wrappers are actually make up a cross-language type system with support for inheritance. Here, each wrapper is corresponded to a type. So with the general definition of search, we can derive new types, subtypes from the search for each individual source. But in this way, we can handle each search as just each of them as just a search. So we can handle all the metadata semantics in a consistent way. Here is a wrapper for Google search. We see that in addition to the metadata schema, we see this selector here, which specifies the MIME type or URL pattern of documents for this wrapper, so the system can know which wrapper to use for this kind of documents. And we have those extraction rules. Here we use the xpath parser, but it's not limited to xpath. We also have PDF parser, like HTML parser, XML parser. This is a wrapper for Yahoo bus search and Bing search and Slashdot search. They are not very different from each other, except for different extraction rules. And in the compilation time, those types defined by wrappers, they are translated and they are compiled into programming language types, which we call metadata classes. Like, we support different kinds of languages. Here shows a Java class for search result. And also, this is a C# version of search. And these metadata classes serve as a mapping between the metadata semantics in the documents to your application, like active domain objects. At runtime, the system selects the, given a URL, the system selects the appropriate wrapper for that document and extract the metadata semantics and take actions on the extracted metadata objects. Those objects are just ordinary programming language objects like defined here. So you can use them in your application. And those objects can also be serialized into different forms, like XML or JSON, and transferred through network or other medium, and deserialized in another system or language, so the semantics can transfer across the system boundaries. And you can also render them into HTML with microdata embedded. Here shows an example of the rendered HTML in which search results from different engines are integrated together. And we think that the meta-metadata transforms the web into an ecosystem of interoperable metadata semantics so that you do not rely on publishers to publish those formal semantics for you to use. You can just extract them. And it supports application development by helping you to extract the metadata semantics and transfer them between systems. So it also comes with a reusable repository, so you can reuse the schema and the extraction rules defined by other people there. It is currently used in several applications. We released it as an open source software. It is funded by Google Summer of Code this year. And we also have, we demoed our creativity support and sense making tool, which is called Info Composer now. And here shows a screenshot of it. This is a an image clipping from our second paper, and here shows all the metadata semantics associated with that paper. In the future, we will work on some more applications using the software, especially trans-surface applications, which transfers semantics across surfaces. And we will promote interoperability with other techniques like RDF. And we encourage people to try the software and propose new use cases for the software to evolve. So that's it. Questions?
I have one. Mm-hmm. I'm wondering about the relationship of your metadata model with RDF, for instance. And do you have some equivalent relationship mechanism, such as a subclass property and subproperties relationship, you know?
Between
different type of metadata.
Oh, I think the relationship between objects are mostly impressed in the like the field name, like it, like the reference relationship between the scholarly articles, papers. It is there is a field called references in a scholarly article, which is a collection of a set of other scholarly articles. So this represents the relationship. And we are working on connecting this kind of relationship with our RDF.
It will be pretty easy for us to generate RDF, but our inherent approach is based on the idea that you should use abstract data types to represent complex data, not kludgy things like triples that you know, that you have to then translate into abstract data types ultimately to operate on them in programs. We propose and have developed this quite substantial mechanism for using abstract data types directly to represent very complex type systems and graphs of interconnected semantic data.
Oh, interesting. Thank you. Thank you. Other questions? Oh, let's thank our speaker.
Thank you.